That's by far the most heartbreaking loss I've ever seen before in all my years of sports. There's depressing. There's that 1990 field goal that the Bills kicker missed. Like, that's pretty depressing. This is pretty devastating. One last shot. They defend it well. He misses it. They just come back from 10. You're at home. And 1/10 of a second dictates that you don't go to the NBA Finals anymore. And now, especially look at the series. Look at the, that's the third in a row they've dropped. It's even now. It's just sad. It's really tough. And I don't know if the Heat are going to have enough juice to win in Game 7. That game's got Boston written all over it. All over. You're at home. They've already done it in this postseason with a Game 7 in dominating fashion at that. I'd be very surprised if Miami came out there and won. It would take a lot from Jimmy Butler. And, you know, I think those guys, I don't know. After that, that's a demoralizing loss. I don't know if they're going to be able to bounce back from it. And, you know, you really got to give a question. Is that the biggest shot in NBA history? It's up there. If we're talking all-time shots, you know, it's definitely up there. Especially if you think about just, like, the history that this series has a chance to impact all the way through. Major history. Major history that no team out of 150 has ever come back from down 0-3. And that evens up the series. And they've already partially made history. They're only the fourth team ever to go to Game 7 after trailing 3-0. So it's tough for Miami. That's, you know, it's probably the team I wanted to see do that. But I don't see a way where Miami can win Game 7. That's why I think when we look at this after the Game 7, we're going to be like, wow, that shot made a huge impact. Mm-hmm.